We had to be at the Cape real early. And got in the car and started heading out for the Cape. Huge crowds. The road you couldn't get through. And I began to think, I'm not even going to get there in time.
The goal is the moon, perhaps man's oldest dream. If all goes well, some 112 hours and 50 minutes after liftoff, Neil Armstrong will step on the lunar surface. It shows what this, the richest nation in history, can do that puts its mind to it.
My very first launch was Apollo 11. I had a press pass, and so I was there and had access. I went up 3 or 4 in the morning, stood by the operations building, and watched these three guys walk by me on the way to the moon. That's like seeing Columbus sail out of port.
We all realize that this is the beginning of the most audacious undertaking that man has ever attempted.
Historically, man going to the moon, that was an amazing thing. The question was whether this would represent a cosmic quest that mankind is going to pursue as a destiny.
From this day to Mars and to Jupiter and even to the heavens beyond. But as long as racism, poverty, hunger, and war prevail on the earth, we as a civilized nation have failed.
Some of us think that the tremendous interest in space travel is, in a sense, a search for another Eden. That man has a kind of guilt about the world in which he lives, and that he has despoiled the place where he is, and that perhaps he ought now, in his maturity, to set out to find another place, a place which man could go to, leaving behind the rusty cage in which his own mistakes have held him.
I was standing near the giant windows in the launch control center, right alongside Werner von Braun and the other people who were responsible for it.
10, 9, ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
I was thinking, what a wonderful animal we are, that we could dream up this and get ourselves off this planet that we were born on and off to another world.
The joys about the space program, everybody felt they had a piece of it, and they did.
Velocity 2,185 feet per second.
This is just the beginning, perhaps, of a new stage in the evolution of the species, something comparable to the crawling of the first amphibian creature out of the primeval swamp onto dry land.
Somebody here a minute ago was saying they are as matter-of-fact and unexcited and calm as if there were taxicab drivers reporting in and saying we're on Maple Street headed for downtown.
Circumstances were such that we had the nation behind us. Everybody was sitting on the edge of their seat. And the awe of the first time we did it, something you never forget.